What do you do? My name is Bear Witness. Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to be talking about The Division 2, but more specifically, we're going to be talking about how they could possibly fix the Dark Zone to make it more approachable to a lot of other players. And we're just going to dive into that topic. But before we do that, friendly reminder that you guys can go ahead and click that like button, that sub button, and that bell if you guys enjoy this video at any point in time during the video. As well as, I just wanted to do a quick explanation that I have spent so long away from the videos, making the videos and things like that for you guys, based on the fact that my sister kind of kidnapped me this weekend, and then I jumped back into the workflow. So I'll have a little bit more regular videos for you guys this week, but that was just me catching up you guys up really quickly. Now, the Dark Zone. One of the biggest and probably the most broken things that I've seen inside of the Dark Zone, and the biggest problem, is matchmaking. The fact that you could be in a solo, or you guys can be playing with a duo or things like that, or basically without a full squad, and they still group you up in player sessions with full squads. This is kind of a problem. They either camp at extraction zones depending on where you're at, even if you want to stay directly outside of the ones where they have the turrets, you can still pretty much sit on the edge of that and still bully people and make it so they can't even come in. Nobody wants to be camped at their spawn. Nobody wants to not be able to play the game, so you're either doing that, or you're in a situation where you have a little chance that you can even fight the 4v1, there's no nomad builds, I don't know about you guys or how long you guys have been playing the game, but I've seen Wids take on multiple groups of enemies with, his build alone. There's tons of YouTubers with amazing builds, and there's players out there that just like the added danger, and yeah, there is supposed to be high risk, high reward, but four-man groups, groups where you're partied up, I really feel like if they were able to kind of section that off or create a matchmaking system that puts, groups into other sessions with groups, as well as putting other players, solo and duo players inside of their own, that could be a big option. A lot of people are asking for a lot of different things when it comes to the Dark Zone, making one giant Dark Zone, things like that. And there's a lot that we haven't seen yet. They could have plans for that. If you guys look, there's a lot of the portions of the map have, areas where the game could be expanded, and it wouldn't be the first time that we've seen the game expanded like that. We're also on next gen consoles, so the options are almost unlimited. So there are a lot of things that they could do in order to try to fix this situation. There's obvious other problems with, PvP or the Dark Zone in general. They made loot a little bit more lucrative. They're making good changes to the game and at increasing loot and things like that, making the Dark Zone a little bit more a little bit better for you to be able to experience and have fun with. But the biggest problem, like I said, is bad matchmaking. So this is definitely something I want you got your opinion on. If you guys enjoyed this video, you guys already know what to do. But yeah, like I said, I really want your comments down below. I really want to know what you guys think. Is this a problem, and do you guys think that the solution is to make different matchmaking brackets, or do you guys think that's over complicating PvP, because that's or the Dark Zone, because I think that's another thing. I think there is a possibility that you could overdo the Dark Zone. You could make it so it's not something that people want to do, based on the fact that they've tried to do so much that they kind of broke it, and there's not something that you can actually have fun with. One of the biggest issues that I do want to poke in my own theory here is that, the option of, playing by yourself. A lot of players will come up with builds that are equally as broken. I mean, there's always going to be a problem. There's always going to be somebody that's going to be able to kick your ass inside of the Dark Zone or inside of PvP in this game, inside of anything. People spend more time than others, and, ultimately, it makes their builds better. It allows them to have a little bit more of an advantage, and there's always going to be that problem. So I don't know if, taking out the initial issue with, there just being groups of players when you don't have groups of players, they'll fix it, or if, players that do play by themselves should just go out and strive to play with other players. Sometimes that doesn't work. Sometimes people just want to play alone, and I guess that's where the PvE content comes into play. But I offer two sides of this argument, and I definitely, like I said one more time, I want to see what you guys have to say. So make sure you guys leave a like on the video, click that sub button if you guys enjoyed the content, and make sure to click that bell to be notified on every single one of my Division videos. And with that being said, guys, I hope you guys have a nice, wonderful rest of your night, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.